Woodworking. Woodworking for Beginners. Written by John Hammer. Narrated by Jim D. Johnston. Table of Contents. Introduction. Chapter 1. The Basics of Woodworking When You Don't Know What You're Doing. Chapter 2. How to Be Safe with Your Hand Tools. Chapter 3. Going from Hand Tools to Power Tools. Chapter 4. The Basics of Sanding and Staining Your Project. Chapter 5. How to Mill a Board to Square 4 Sides. Chapter 6. The Basics of Cutting Mortise and Tenon Joints. Chapter 7. Top Tips to Get Started Right. Chapter 8. Creating Your Own End Table. Chapter 9. Creating a Bench. Chapter 10. Creating a Bookshelf. Chapter 11. Make Your Own Lawn Chair. Chapter 12. A Dog Bed for Your Best Friend. Chapter 13. Picnic Table. Final Note. Conclusion. Introduction. Woodworking is a hobby that people have been enjoying for years. While in the past it was used more as a way to make furniture and other things that you needed in the home, it is now something that you can do for fun or to showcase your talent in the home. Even though the reason for woodworking has changed throughout the years, there are still many of the same techniques that you can use to get the most out of all your projects. This guidebook is going to take some time to look at the process of woodworking and how you can use it to make some amazing projects. We'll start out with some of the basics of woodworking, such as which hand tools and power tools that you need in order to get started, how to stay safe, how to do a few simple projects, and then moving on to some projects that are a little more complex. When you're done with this guidebook, you'll be able to get started on some of your own projects and really impress your friends. When you are ready to get started with woodworking and you want to go from beginner to expert in no time, make sure to check out this guidebook to help you get started. Chapter 1. The Basics of Woodworking When You Don't Know What You're Doing. Woodworking can be a fun experience. Learning how to make something with your own two hands can be a dream for many people. But you may be worried about getting started simply because you don't have any experience about woodworking. This book is the right place to get started if you have never done anything with woodworking or if you know very little and want to get started. First, we're going to take a look at some of the basics that you'll need just to get started, the tools that you'll need, the space that can make it easier, and even the various techniques that will help you to get some practice and get started with woodworking. Pick out the basic tools. The first thing to realize here is that you're only going to really need a few tools when you get started. Sometimes it is tempting to get started and go out and purchase a ton of expensive tools for your projects before you've even gotten started. In reality, you will end up spending a ton of money, and many of those tools will just sit in the closet and go to waste. Learn some of the basic tools that are needed to get started, and then only get those, at least until you get to some more challenging projects that need the other tools. First, let's look at the hand tools that you'll need to have with you. Some of these include a drill, a screwdriver, screws, nails, a hammer. These may seem obvious, but in the beginning, these are really the only tools that you'll need, along with the wood, so that you can work on your first few projects and get the basics of woodworking down. Another tool that you may want to get at this time is a speed square. This tool may not be as familiar to you as the ones above, so learning what it is all about can make a difference. A speed square is going to be a small, triangular-shaped tool. There are a lot of ways where you may want to use the speed square in your woodworking projects, including it can help you to make accurate angle cuts, either 90 or 45 degrees, using a hand or circular saw. You can use it as a protractor to help you make some angles that are accurate and make the project easier to work on. You can use the speed square to help measure lines that need to be perpendicular to the edge of the wood board, for being able to measure and mark the 45-degree angles on your projects. You can also use it to know the width of the board in relation to the cut that you want to make. As you can see, there are a lot of capabilities that can come with the speed square. Even with this in mind, the main purpose is to measure out lines quickly and easily, in the hopes of saving time and frustration in the process. You can pick from steel, aluminum, or plastic, and the cost is not too bad for how often you will use this piece in your work. Purchase one that is high quality so that it lasts for a long time and the measurements are accurate. The next tool that you need is a saw. There are many different types of saws that you can purchase, and we could spend a whole book discussing which saws are the best and how each of them work. Without a good saw, it's going to get pretty hard to cut through the wood, so pick out one that's in good shape and sharp enough to get through the wood. The most common saws that you'll want to consider for your projects include a miter saw, a table saw, a reciprocating saw, a jigsaw, a circular saw. Depending on the projects that you decide to work with, you may need a few different ones of these saws, but you can take a look at your intended projects and go from there. You'll also need a clamp. This clamp is important because it holds your wood in place when you're cutting through it, making it easier to cut through the wood and get nice straight lines. The most basic clamp that you can purchase for your projects includes the C-clamp. The C-clamp is nice because it is able to latch onto any table that you're using, so if you don't have a special woodworking table to start with, it will still work. These clamps are going to come in a lot of sizes, but usually range from 4 to 8 inches. These clamps get more expensive the larger you want them to be. You can also pick up a sander, unless you want to put all the work into the product and then have it feel rough to the touch or give splinters to those around you, then you must consider investing in a sander that can help you smooth it down. When you get started with woodworking, the sander will probably be one of the most expensive things that you purchase, but they are definitely worth it. There are several sanders that you can go with, but most woodworkers will pick either an orbital sander or a belt sander. The orbital sander is the best for most beginner projects to work with, such as furniture and some other small wooden trinkets. In addition to purchasing a good sander, remember that you'll need to invest in some sandpaper. Depending on the wood types that you'll pick for the project, there are also some different paper grades that you can pick based on how smooth you would like the project to be when done. The finer the sander grade, the smoother you are able to get the product to be. These are the most basic tools that you'll need to get started. Some other projects that you pick can have some other tools that you may need. If you find that several of your projects need the same additional tool, or you plan to work on the same project quite a few times, then it makes economical sense to purchase that tool, along with the others that we talked about. Understand how much space you'll need. Now that you know a bit about the tools that you'll need to invest in to get started on your projects, it is important to know more about the space that you'll need to use to have room. Unlike other hobbies, you're not going to travel somewhere else in order to do it, and most people are not able to rent out space to do this. This means that you're going to need to find room somewhere in your home. Some people will work in their basement, on a porch, in the backyard, or even in the garage. You can pick any location that you would like, as long as there is enough room to fit the boards and all of your tools. Another thing to consider here is that if you plan to spend a lot of time sanding, then you'll want to make sure that you're going with a space where sanding dust can show up without ruining things. It is known that there is a lot of dust that's going to accumulate from sanding, and it can be considered damaging to your lungs. If you do spend a lot of your time sanding your projects, you must consider wearing a sand mask, and that you can clean the area often to keep yourself and your lungs safe. The amount of lighting that is in the space needs to be adequate. The first reason for this is that it is important to be able to see the wood well when you're working on it. It is really hard to mark, cut, and configure the wood if you have to squint the whole time that you're doing the work. The second reason is that a good source of light will make it easier to line up the saw blades to the measurements you made correctly. If you work on your projects inside the home somewhere, then make sure that you have adequate sources of light to make it easier. Each person is going to pick a different spot in order to do these projects. You just need to make sure that there is enough room and enough light for the projects you choose. If you're just doing small end tables, you won't need as much room as if you're doing larger kitchen tables or some of the other bigger projects. You can take a look at the tools and the sizes for each project you want to work on, and then choose the space from there. Learn the different techniques. There are a lot of different techniques that you are able to use when you do woodworking. This is true whether you want to sand the project, learn how to measure and cut the boards, how to stain the project, and even how to finish the project. What works the best for some people may not always work the best for you, so try out some different techniques to see how much you like those options. When it comes to cutting the boards, you may find that working with a specific saw works the best for you. Doing the boards as you go along with the project or doing them all ahead of time can help. You may want to work with someone else before you decide which method to go with to see what seems to work best, and then try out a few different options until you get it right. Sanding is probably the part where you'll need to really work on the techniques. Many times the project will recommend working with a power sander because this is easier and can speed up the work. But if you don't like the feel of the power tool or find that you just can't get the pressure right and you keep making the project look bad with it, there's nothing wrong with using your hands in order to sand off the project. No matter what part of the project you're working on, you will find that there are many techniques to use. None of them are necessarily any better than the others, so go ahead and experiment and see what you can do to make.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.